Hey yo, what's up? Well, the stress has to be prolonged a little bit because the Nazis haven't distributed the auto rations yet. So, yeah, auto rations? You know, what the fuck? What kind of fucking world are we living in here? Yeah, auto rations, that's basically what it is. Who's allowed to have a car and who's not allowed to have a car. And every year you have to pray someone takes mercy on you and lets you own your car. Fucking bullshit. But anyway, lots of things. I don't want to harp on the stupid Adidas shoes because Spike and Big Irish already covered that. And I agree wholeheartedly. Just the look of them, I instantly thought of, you know, when you see on TV the prison shackles, when they cuff your wrists and your ankles all chained together. It's like, really, if they, I don't really think that someone just thought that that would be cool. I think they're just plain laughing in our faces and saying, ha ha, look at all these stupid fucking people who are gonna wear these things like the prisoners they are. And you are, you're prisoners of society. Everything that you buy into, you know, you're buying into the way society is. I mean, I do it too. I've got a pair of Nikes. I won't lie. I wanted them shits because they were comfortable. And they last a little bit longer than the $14 Walmart shoes that I usually get. So, you know, that's just how it is. But, man, fuck this. Really. Man, there's just no words for it. But there is something else I've come across lately, and I haven't had the time to go through and read it or research it, but I got an email about it. I'm on, like, some different mailing lists about, you know, current events and issues and things going on in the world. And one of the things that came up the other day was that Obama's trying to pass something that says that everything that we think we own, we really don't. That all of the products we have, anything that's, you know, made in another country or whatever, it will give the country and the manufacturers intellectual property rights over absolutely everything, making it illegal for you to sell anything you own, from electronics such as computers, video cameras, cell phones, TVs, DVD players, to the clothes we wear. They're not really ours because the intellectual property rights would be with the manufacturer and the country that they come from. So, yeah, so you can't sell anything. And it's just that they're trying to get more money for the top 1%. If we cannot exchange used goods, that means everybody has to go out and buy everything brand new off the shelves, which of course gives millions and millions and billions more to the top 1%, the CEOs of all the companies that make everything. And there's like just a handful, like less than a dozen companies that own absolutely everything there is. So, if that comes to pass, you know, if we don't really own anything, then why should we have to fucking pay for it? I would want everyone to revolt. I mean, hundreds to thousands of people just go into the big box stores and take everything. Just fucking rob the stores blind and empty. Because if we don't own anything, why should we have to fucking pay for it? It's just such bullshit. And I can't believe something like that would even be proposed. You know, I really don't know a great deal about the whole fair trade thing, but I'm all for, you know, bringing the jobs back home, making outsourcing illegal, I've said it before, bringing manufacturing back here. I know we owe shitloads, like trillions upon trillions, to China and shit like that, and, you know, China's basically, you know, got us by the balls because everything we have comes from there and whatnot. But if I were in power, I would find a way to slowly phase out buying shit from China, starting with all food products, including pet products, because all it does is kill people and kill animals here anyway. So, yeah, I'd phase that out and start producing everything here. So, yeah, you do have to pay American workers more than anywhere else in the world, but we need the jobs here. And not only that, but we could still keep prices reasonable while paying American workers a reasonable wage and giving them full benefits and everything that they need if the top CEOs and executives made a little less money. Instead of like a personal take home of $60 billion a year, maybe your personal take home should only be $1 billion a year. And use the extra money to pay American workers and give them benefits. Oh, boo-hoo, world's smallest violin playing My Heart Bleeds for You. Poor things, not gonna get $100 billion a year. Oh, wah, wah, boo-hoo, wah. Yeah, they could take a little less fucking money and still be filthy, stinking rich. So there's definitely room for improvement, and where to make the cuts is to make the cuts at the top. Stop making the cuts at the very bottom. You know, shit has got to fucking change. That's all I can say. Peace out, fam. Woop woop.